Thank you. Following Mr. Pathak's welcome note, it is my privilege to introduce Shri Subhash Ghai ji, a stalwart in the world of filmmaking and education. Shri Ghai's industry address promises to provide invaluable insights into the current landscape and the future trajectory of our industry. Shri Subhash Ghai ji.
Good morning, everyone. सब जोर से बोलेंगे गुड मॉर्निंग तो अच्छा लगेगा. दैट इज़ द स्पिरिट, दैट इज़ द स्पिरिट. आज बहुत अलग से सवाल होने चाहिए. अगर रूटीन क्वेश्चन तो पाठक साहब पूछ ही लेंगे आपसे, लेकिन ऐसा होना चाहिए कि ये लगे कि वी हैव इवॉल्व्ड समवेयर एंड वी चेंज द एटमॉस्फेयर ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ पैनल स्पीकिंग. इट शुड नॉट बी बोरिंग even at the cost of some humor around with us. So he asked me one question, what has changed since 1997 to 2024 at Fiki Frames. Galiyan saaf ho gayi hain, road badal gayi hain, makan redevelopment bhi aa gaye hain, metros aa gaye hain, plane badh gaye hain. जितना भी डेवलपमेंट आपने देखा है हमारे कंट्री में, फिल्में अलग हो गई हैं, OTT आ गया है, एवरीथिंग इज चेंज टुडे. और इसका एक कंट्रीब्यूशन, एक फैक्टर और एक मूवमेंट एंड एक इनिशिएटिव का क्रेडिट मैं फिक्की को भी देता हूँ. बिकॉज 1997, we were always discussing these panels, what will happen to our country, how we are going to take forward this country in our thinking, in our thoughts, in our action, and in our vision. And I remember very specifically, ki I used to say, ki India needs human development, more than any kind of development. India need intellect development. India need artists. India need skilled people. And that time, people were reacting. Even my friends in bureaucracy also said, ki bhaiya ye sunte sunte to 30 saal ho gaye hain, abhi tak to kuch nahi ho sakta. But I must give the full credit to the government, subsequent government, and particularly the bureaucracy. They understood the things and they took it further on the insistence on recognizing Fiki. I remember that government recognized Fiki that time, and they recognized every initiative and they discovered this is a good platform to bring all those people who are responsible and to interact with each other. And let's have their point of view. And I remember the how media education was important. I used to tell that time. I have been making films, as you know, see, from a simple boy from Delhi and going, doing my BCom and going to a whistling board, FTI for my training in cinema. Then I started acting, writing, directing, producing, corporate, and then education. At my Whistling Wolf Film School, now today they have 1,100 students in media and entertainment. And I'm happy, now we are making filmmakers. I used to make films now. So journey has been quite joyful and with a lot of challenges, a lot of struggles. But I remember, I want to point out here, in this on this occasion, is when I had money in 1997. I had an experience. I had made 12 blockbusters films. And I had a lot of money. And I said, what to do with this money? Believe me. Is paise ka kya karunga main? So mere office mein, in my office, there were a lot of newcomers coming, pouring in. The talent, actors, writers, singers. He said, you have given an opportunity to so many stars. You have produced so many stars as a choreographer, as a director, as an actor. Why don't you give us a chance? And they were all boys and girls were from different states, from Bihar, from Northeast. And they said, we do not know anyone in Bombay, sir. So I said, Bruce, I make a film in one film in 2 years. I cannot give you all of you chances. And that time I remember I met Mr. Dilip Kumar, that was, he was my favorite actor and friend. And I asked him, should I open a studio, a film studio like Raj Kapoor studio, like Gurudat studio, Nishant Ram, or should I open a film school? He said, film school. He said, you should work on it, Subhash. And I know you're a person who would like to share with the younger generation. Because you like new talent, you like new people, young kids to groom. And from there, I started my work on opening one of the finest film school or media school in India. I went abroad and visited 32 film schools from Europe to Japan to America, every country. And I did my research work and I was surprised to see one thing which I never knew. I was educated like a kid, an ordinary pass marks. Zyada koi first class, first studio nahi tha usme. Kyunki I used to ask myself ki if the whole examination is based on 6 questions in a year, why should I study whole year? I will ask my friend, send me 12 questions, I will cram it, and I will have a pass marks. There is no need to study in a study. There is a difference between a study and cramming a thing. Pass hone ka matlab hota tha. So that time I realized in America that they educate their children about media and entertainment sector from the class of fifth standard. From fifth standard, that students have to take one optional subject, either sports or media. And we didn't have in India. We could never think about that. And that time, I came to know that we are living on a memory-based education in India, when they are developing their skill-based education. So I could understand the difference between these two. I'm talking about the journey, you know, how I got this. And then I came back again to the FICCI events and to various government. And I told them, listen, sir, we should develop the skill-based education. I was from FTI, fine. And then I designed the whole course with my film industry across, best of the people, best of the directors. They designed the courses for me. And we worked very hard for 5 years to design the courses and the philosophy of education. It's not a building of whistling goods or mortar and bricks which works. What is important is that how do you visualize and how to make a vision to educate your children right from their toddler age, right from their, when they are kids, newly born kids. You could see the newly born kids is attracted to certain toys of science, or toys of wonder toys. And you come to know within 3 years ki ye banega, iska interest yahan hai. But there is no opportunity for the children for the 5 years to 10 years ki usko us direction mein bheja jaye, because there were no schools like that, there were no courses like that. There was no education like that. So it was important for us that we could interact with each other, and I developed the whole thing. And 2006 May I started Whistling Woods with 80 students. Today we have 1100 students and we have 3700 students working in media. Now wherever I go to any studio, I find my students there, and 4,000 students working in the media companies is a huge joy for anyone. And what we did was, what I get the compliment, best compliment from their bosses and CEO, is that they are very good. The most important is they are very humble. They are a learner. They feel they are still students. They are not masters. And that is the best quality from the Michelin students, from Michelin goodies. So that is called the soft side of an artist or a technician when you develop them. That is very, very important that you profess and you infuse the philosophy of human development first in him. He has to be a good person to be a good artist. He has to be a good artist to be a good technician or a craftsman. And when these things happen together, then you see the country develops with a different generation. Gone are the generation like us, where we had nothing. But we have to think tomorrow generation that how we can go further. And I'm very happy that initiatives like this are here to interact further. And 1997 came out, the 2010 was again a remarkable year. Then 2015 made the education policies, came 2022. All the skill education, I have been a chairman of Media Entertainment Skill Council under the Skill Ministry. And I remember that we had a lovely time and understood it. And they have progressed so much today that I feel like to give a big clap for them, for Media. Thank you. Thank you very much. I don't think I should speak too long. Neither do ghante lag jayenge.
Audience would love it.
No, thank you. Audience would love to understand, want to know ki Madhuri Dixit kaise artist bani, unka kya gossip hua, you know, how you took Jackie Shroff. Ye sab dusri baatein hain. But sab baatein experience ke baad, I can tell you one thing. Most important thing, that look at your small kid of your country, of your family, of your society, and think of it once, how much you can contribute in developing him, his taste or his skill, his art hidden in him. Don't force him education. Don't give him a forced education. Give him love. Feed him. Ask him questions. Today is a day when education has to be with the interactive class, interactive, not a classroom. कि एक आदमी बोल रहे हैं 40 सुन रहे हैं अभी एक एजुकेशन है कि मैं बच्चों को पूछता हूँ आप कितना जानते हैं आप मुझे बताएंगे फर्स्ट सो इंटरेक्शन इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग टुडे इन एजुकेशन आज स्टाइल चेंज हो गया है बिकॉज चिल्ड्रन आर मच अहेड देन अस देयर आर 3 जनरेशन अहेड ऑफ अस बिकॉज ऑफ द डिजिटल रिवोल्यूशन रिसेंटली वी मस्ट एक्सेप्ट दैट But ask them to be creative, more skilled. Help them, support them. Don't force them. Ask them what they need. We are there with you. That's my only suggestion to every establishment, every organization. See that how can you help them in developing themselves, the kids. Thank you.
Shri Subhash Ghai ji, ladies and gentlemen. Sir, it's always so insightful listening to you. Thank you so much. Next. I call upon Shri Atul Kumar Tiwari, the Honorable Secretary of Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Government of India, for an inaugural address. His leadership and guidance in skill development is pivotal in shaping the future workforce of the media and entertainment.
इसमें आगे बढ़े entertainment sector skill council के माध्यम से CBSE के साथ higher education के साथ बहुत सारी कोर्सेज स्कूल में चलाए थे जिसका मैं कुछ उल्लेख करना चाहूँगा वो शायद एनिमेशन हो एंड अदर सच कोर्सेज के बारे में काफ़ी लोगों में विस्तार पड़ा है और बहुत सारी संस्थाएं ट्रेनिंग संस्थाएं हमारे साथ जुड़ रही हैं जहाँ पे बच्चों को छात्रों को हम इस तरह के कोर्सेज दे के मीडिया ट्रेनमेंट के साथ हम तैयार कर पाए हमारे पास
Thank you.